Gauri Lankesh was arguably one of the finest journalists in the country. She was one of the few women editors. She epitomized feisty, courageous, investigative journalism. She could have had a cushy job in an English language publication. She chose to work in Kannada. Gauri held truth to power. And because she was able to communicate to such large numbers of people, that was a source of her strength. It also made her relatively more vulnerable. And which is why the attack came on her. Today we see in India the spaces for free expression shrinking. And the dastardly, ghastly murder of Gauri Lankesh is an attempt to stifle voices. And if we keep quiet, those who are responsible for her murder would have succeeded. So we have to all speak up. We all have to speak up for what is our fundamental right. That is the right to free expression. A journalist shouldn't be a stenographer. A journalist has to play the role of an antagonist and adversary to those who are in positions of power and authority. And if we don't speak up, then Gauri would have died in vain. Her martyrdom would have been in vain. If we speak up, I'm hopeful there'll be 100 other, if not 1,000 other, Gauri Lankeshes will be born. Gauri Lankesh, who held truth to power, who could play the role of an antagonist to those who were abusing their discretionary power and authority. It is a defining moment in the contemporary Indian history of the media. It's a defining moment in the whole discourse on free expression. Because I think we've reached a stage in our country where those who are in power, they're becoming increasingly intolerant of those who are critical of them. And it's gone beyond intolerance. It's gone to liquidating. And I think this kind of a situation is in a sense almost unprecedented. It's reminiscent of the days of the emergency in the mid-70s, except that this is an unspoken, unwritten emergency. But the kind of repression, the kind of pressures, the kind of intimidation, the kind of harassment that we are seeing against those who speak their minds, those who speak against right-wing extremism, I mean, that's perhaps something that's unprecedented. And I really hope Gauri hasn't died in vain.